Declaration of Independence in the other. He's Sean Thompson, and this is the Sean Thompson Show.
This looks like a job for me, so everybody just follow me, because we need a little controversy, because it feels so easy without me.
We're going to jump into the topic of the ridiculousness of the banks and the market. We are. But I had a conversation today with an old friend of my family that I know all of my life. He's an older man. And we had a conversation today. He caught the show. He didn't know about the show. He's been out of town for years. And he's been listening for a month, and he called me up, and he wanted to go over some old times in my grandfather's auto parts store with me today. And at the end of it, he was pointing out to me all of the men that I knew from Melrose Park, all of the old timers, Babe, the old mayor, all of them. And he said, you know, they were Democrats. How did this happen? And it struck me, there are still people out there that think there are American Democrats of yesteryear, and just because they're old with wrinkled asses and in diapers like Joe Biden, they're still Democrats. These are not Democrats. These are mafia members. Not the old mafia where the guys rolled dice and they loaned money to each other and they beat each other up when they didn't pay. But the Marxist, communist, Fourth Reich mafia. And when you look at that, it doesn't give you that sick feeling where we're losing and we're doing... That's a feeling you have when you care about somebody, when you share a goal, when you work with somebody, and you're trying to improve the company, and they're arguing about the best way to do that. No, 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 that's politics of old. The goal of this mafia is to destroy things, not make them better. That was never more obvious than last night. Joe Biden flies into Canada at night and then walks in the house with Trudeau and his wife. Now, he can't answer questions about the border, as the Canadian reporters want. He walks in the house and he said, before he does, he says, we're staying. He goes in the house, and where did Joe Biden stay? Where did Joe Biden stay? And are there still people out there who do not know who Justin Trudeau is? Do you think Justin Trudeau is just a good-looking guy, used to be a teacher? Justin Trudeau is the son of Pierre Trudeau. Pierre Trudeau is a very interesting guy. See, and Justin Trudeau's mother was lovely woman, beautiful, beautiful, but a schizophrenic, checked herself into a mental institution for 5 years, well-known tramp, slept with everybody from Fidel Castro to some Saudi guy in Jordan, who knows, and not to mention she disappeared for a weekend with, I don't know if it's the Rolling Stones or some band. Anyway, that's his mother. His mother's a tramp and a schizophrenic, but the father started out like a good guy. But very, very early on in 1973, he took a trip to China. China, and back then Mao Zedong was still in charge. Here's a little bit of Pierre Trudeau, because you got to know who you're dealing with. See, Joe Biden's not a Democrat. He's an asset. He's a whore. Anybody could buy this wrinkled-ass dimwit back when he could remember his address. Now it's just easy.
The Trudeau trip to China was a great personal success. He had several marks to his credit before he set foot in China. This time, he came from the land of Norman Bethune, a growing legend in China, the Gravenhurst, Ontario surgeon who's buried with other martyrs.
Now, Squirrel, to help you out, because you're a young man. This was scandalous at the time, 1973. However, the first scandalous politician to go to China and work it all out was Nixon. Nixon laid the groundwork, and China followed. I mean, Canada followed, or Canada, as it's known by the spokes idiot for the White House. So when Pierre did it, he didn't just go and have a meeting and come back. He stayed for quite a while.
Chinese Revolution. Trudeau's interest in China was already well known to its leaders. He'd written about them somewhat sympathetically. He struck them as a friend, and of course he had...
Now, in 1973, Squirrel, communist sympathizing wasn't as accepted as it is today, where idiot, fat slob, Chicago teacher union thugs teach it and promote it. Back then, this was frowned upon, communist sympathizing, because back then, people knew what that ideology led to.
It led Canada into recognizing Peking before the global flood began. Understandably then, the mood was good, with both sides warming to each other. But it's hard to be sure what, in concrete terms, will flow from all this goodwill. Exchanges galore, scientific, medical, cultural. The agreements, to quote one Canadian official, cover everything but the kitchen sink. The Juno advisors would argue they obtained far more than they came for, including the personal endorsement of Chairman Mao for the new direction, Sino-Canadian relations. But frankly, they aimed low just in case they failed. The Chinese sincerity will watch very carefully in the months and years ahead. What, for example, will flow from the new trade agreement? There was nothing specific in the agreement signed in Peking. And the new deal on consulates, will the location of Canada's new consulate in Canton achieve what Ottawa wants, a clearinghouse for Chinese immigrants to be reunited with their families in Canada? And will there be, in fact as well as in promise, easier access for Canadian businessmen generally? The Chinese have let in only the businessmen selling the goods they want.
So you want to know how China achieved what's called favored nation status? Is because it had corrupted those political leaders that could give it favored nation status, so it never had to abide by any of the rules, any of the taxes, any of the costs. And that's what made them very, very rich. But what else they did is intellectually, they infiltrated politicians and parties. The Trudeau family is very well infiltrated. Not the whore mother, she was just easy peasy. But the father, who would go on to be prime minister twice after this. And it's very important to hear him.
We discussed a great many subjects. Chairman Mao asked a lot of questions about Canada, its geography, its climate in terms of production, particularly of agricultural goods, wheat in particular. He was very interested in our northern reaches, in questions relating to the Arctic. From there, we went to other areas of the world. We discussed the Middle East at some length. We had some general discussions on problems of peace in the world.
This was over the course of days, Squirrel. Days.
And we had a further exchange in matters of Canada's history and its evolution, and even some discussion of its parliamentary system.
I wonder, Pierre, you communist sympathizing traitor, I wonder when you were talking with him, if you knew, if you understood who you were talking to. You see, Squirrel, when they talk about dictators who are murderers, everyone says Hitler. That's how you can tell how smart they are. Hitler wasn't even an appetizer to Uncle Joe Stalin, who wasn't even close to the entree of Mao Zedong.
Who was the biggest mass murderer in the history of the world? Most people probably assume that the answer is Adolf Hitler, architect of the Holocaust. Others might guess Soviet dictator Joseph Stalin, who may indeed have managed to kill even more innocent people than Hitler did, many of them as part of a terror famine that likely took more lives than the Holocaust. But both Hitler and Stalin were outdone by Mao Zedong. From 1958 to 1962, his Great Leap Forward policy led to the deaths of up to 45 million people. He's
4 years, 45 million people. 4 years. That's the Great Leap Forward. Where have I heard that forward before? Oh yeah, Baraki likes big butts and he cannot lie.
Recently making it the biggest episode of mass murder ever recorded. Mao thought that he could catapult his country past its competitors by herding villagers across the country into giant people's communes. In pursuit of a utopian paradise, everything was collectivized. People had their work, homes, land, belongings, and livelihoods taken from them. In collective canteens, food, distributed by the spoonful according to merit, became a weapon used to force people to follow the party's every dictate. As incentives to work were removed, coercion and violence were used instead to compel famished farmers to perform labor on poorly planned irrigation projects, while fields were neglected. A catastrophe of gargantuan proportions ensued.
So they had a problem. They killed all the planters, they poisoned all the fields, and they did it to kill all the people, just the ones that were making waves. And then there's the link between Xi Jinping and America. Do you know what that link is, Squirrel? I bet you don't.
Nestled along the banks of the Mississippi River, the town of Muscatine in Iowa is a world away from China, both geographically and culturally. But it's a special place for Chinese President Xi Jinping, and also the heartland for China-U.S. relations. Visiting in 1985 as part of an agricultural delegation, she stayed with a local family in its unassuming home at 2911 Bonnie Drive. And now the house is open to the public, dubbed as the Sino-US Friendship House. As vice president, she returned to Iowa in 2012 to meet some of his old friends. He gave his Iowa hosts a banner as a present.
Yeah, and that house where this communist stayed is a museum. Now, why would it be a museum? It gives a rip that this idiot went and stayed there. I don't understand any of that. But then it all becomes very clear because the new Mao Zedong is Xi Jinping.
China's rubber-stamp parliament has overwhelmingly voted to abolish presidential term limits, clearing the way for Xi Jinping to remain president for life. The move makes Xi the most powerful president since Mao Zedong and highlights his meteoric ascent.
Now you may ask, what does this have to do with a talk radio show that talks about American politics and business? I pay attention to what they say. It doesn't make sense to me. Joe Biden, who never stays up past 5, travels there at night, spends the evening. Where? We don't know. And then when he comes out, he says this.
Xi Jinping asked me in the Tibetan Plateau, can I define America? I could have...
No. Is a Tibetan Plateau like the Himalayas world? I don't know.
America is a nation that can be defined in a single word. I was in the foothills of the Himalayas with Xi Jinping.
A lot of time with Xi Jinping. A lot of time reminiscing. And Canada, by the way, is embroiled in its own election fraud. Did you know that, Squirrel? I bet you didn't know that. It's true.
The Prime Minister is set to speak to reporters this afternoon following an announcement with Ontario Premier Doug Ford. It comes amid growing calls for the Trudeau government to call an inquiry into allegations of Chinese foreign interference into the 2021 federal election. Opposition MPs are demanding Trudeau's chief of staff testify at House of Commons committee investigating election interference. With more...
See, in Canada, they accuse the Chinese Communist Party of needing the son of the communist sympathizer, Pierre, this idiot, Justin, who's a combination of his schizophrenic mother and his communist father. They need him in that spot. They need Joe Biden in that spot. It's starting to make a lot of sense to me why we're in this predicament. So to assume that the Biden administration is looking for American success, the premise is wrong. The Biden administration is a traitor. He is an asset of the Communist Party. That's why he's always mentioning Xi Jinping. And that's why he's always giving that Democrat lipstick on the pig. We're going to make it better. Opportunity. What did he say to this idiot?
Xi Jinping asked me in the Tibetan Plateau, could I define America? And I could have said the same thing if he asked about Canada. I said, yes, one word. And I mean it, one word. Possibilities. Nothing is beyond our...
I think the one word you're searching for, wrinkled ass, diaper wearing, dementia dimwit, is traitor. You, Trudeau, your entire party are traitors. They're not looking for American achievement. You're looking for American failure. That's what we're experiencing right now. The good news is, even the Saudis, who were never really known for their sense of humor, and if you ever watch Saudi TV, in particular, their version of Benny Hill, this guy looks like he washes his testicles first with the washcloth, then his face. Even he's making fun of Joe Biden.
God bless you. God bless America.
And they're mimicking Joe Biden. Walking around, doesn't know if it's Tuesday or July, and they even mimic the relationship between the Chinese communist sympathizer Trudeau and the Chinese American asset, who was installed, not elected. I wonder if there's a connection between the election fraud in Canada and the election fraud we call Joe Biden. 312-642-5600.
Make money, smoke cigars, and live free on the Sean Thompson Show on AM 560. The Answer. AM 560. The Answer.
You may remember at one of those Fourth Reich meetings, Xi Jinping, who, by the way, speaks English. He lived here. He does that Putin thing where they pretend they don't know what you're saying. He wanted to pull the son of a whore and a communist sympathizer to Mao Zedong. He wanted to pull him over and really let him know. Shut your mouth. The leaks are getting annoying. There's enough, maybe, there's enough smart people to see what a traitor you are as well. You can't hear the background noise because our microphone picked it up. It's through a translator. As Xi Jinping is talking to Trudeau like he was his mother. And he says to him, everything we discussed is leaking to the papers. That's not acceptable. And Trudeau stood there. Same look on his face his mother had on Monday after the Rolling Stones dropped her off on the curb. Trudeau walks away like a scared little dog.
Paula, you spoke with Trudeau about China, specifically those suspected Chinese spy balloons.
Yeah, I gotta tell you, Jake, that's all anyone can talk about in this town and this country, for that matter, is Chinese interference, and in so many forms. Not just the balloons and, quite frankly, buoys that they found in the Arctic, but also a more insidious kind of Chinese surveillance, and that would involve interference into elections or even spying that is going on in this country. Some of it has implicated the Trudeau government itself. They deny that they had any knowledge of this. But again, these are thorny issues that, as Phil said, President Biden and the...
They have the same tumult going on in China. I mean, in Canada, excuse me, because they recognize China as what it is. Infiltrating and sabotaging the principles of freedom, the principles of sovereignty. This plan is working exactly as they need it to. And they have all the key positions, all the key members placed in all the key places. And it's the reason, do not get upset as Joe Biden implements and insists on policies that'll bankrupt and weaken us. That's what he's been paid for.
So today, I applaud China for stepping up, excuse me, I applaud Canada.
Oh, don't get your notes mixed up, diaper wearer. Ta-da!
You can tell what I'm thinking about China. Won't get into that yet.
I can tell what you're thinking. I know exactly what you are, traitor. That's what you are. Jim and Lyle.
Sean, fascinating. This is why I learn only from you. Other talk shows I don't. You're telling me that in 1973, Mao is asking Pierre Trudeau about his agricultural fields in the North American continent and its topography. They had designs back then. What is this? Is gold? Where did you get this tape? What is it?
You could Google it. It'll be on YouTube. I think it's still on YouTube, right, Honey Bunny? Where did I send it to you? YouTube or Rumble? I examine all of it. You know what? We're going to put you on hold. She's going to send it to you because this is the thing you have to understand. This didn't happen overnight. Joe Biden is merely the close destination that the Chinese Communist Party has set America on since the early 70s. Richard Nixon.
Absolutely.
And his fat guy whose name, he's still alive too, the son of a gun's never died. What's his name?
Kissinger.
And Henry Kissinger were also the useful whores. Richard Nixon, I don't know if you know this about him, he was busted. He grew up in the Depression, poverty stricken. For $50, he'd smack his mother in the face with a shovel. He was always a whore. Piece of garbage that he is. So that's why. Hold on, we're going to get it to you. Thank you very much. Michael, Southside, Mike.
Hey, I usually don't call in this early, but I talked to your little honey bunny there, and I'm 61. My father was a professor of economics on the college campuses in the late 60s and early 70s, and he was always the odd man out because he was, you know, properly catechized Catholic, so he understood catechesis. He was an economist. He understood capitalism, and he was always the odd man out. And I was like so well versed in everything that you're talking about right now. I mean, right now I'm looking in the book Thomas Sowell Marxism, right? So it's
now
here.
What is Kamala Harris's father? Kamala Harris's father identified himself as a Marxist economist at USC. Everybody want to know? Oh, I don't know why she's there. I mean, aside from Willie Wilson and her being the fluffer. She's been groomed as a Marxist her whole life. Willie Brown. Did I say Willie Wilson again? I get them all confused.
And
Willie
all Brown. These people love Bernie Sanders, who went to Russia on his honeymoon. I mean, it's just, I mean, these Americans.
During the Cold War. During the Cold War.
Yeah.
Now, if you go to Russia for your honeymoon, it's just because you want your dollar to go farther or your ruble.
Well, and you know, and these Americans who hate Trump, the reason why they hate Trump is they hate an alpha male. These world leaders who are males on the world scene are the most effeminate.
The other thing is, Trump wasn't groomed in this. Trump has been saying for decades he did not like the relationship. Trump wanted America to succeed. The saboteurs we call politicians want America to fail. Thank you very much. I'm going to play another one. Do I have time? Ah, son of a gun. Is it really 4:30? All right, hang on. I got another one for you. I got a lot of more for you. Quote Mr. T, most underrated actor. He should have won an Academy Award. I'll be back after this.
He will never negotiate his constitutional rights with the government. Live free or die on the Sean Thompson Show. AM 560, The Answer. AM 560, The Answer.
Remind me to talk about the Syrian airstrikes too, Squirrel, when we clear the board. I'm sure those will go as famously as the Barack Obama 90% of the drone strikes killing innocent people. But this time, I'm sure they got it all solved. Candace, Mount Pleasant, Wisconsin.
Sean, that was an amazing opening. I hope that you'll have on Michael Mauer, who wrote The White Pill, which is an amazing book. But if anybody doesn't want to read, they can just watch him on YouTube on all the interviews that he's done on his book. This book documents everything. He went on his own Beck show, that's where I saw him. I've never read his book. But I've seen him around, you know,
Why do we have a bad connection? What are you talking into a Campbell's soup can? What are you talking about? The NSA got
Sorry. My speakerphone went off. Sorry. Anyway, I was talking about the book The White Pill by Michael Malice.
All right,
and
yes.
He documents everything in communism, and he's been shoo-shooing, you know, all these conservatives because they don't know much about communism. So I'm so glad you're talking about it. I hope you'll have one on the show because that is an amazing book.
We will
conservatives
effort.
Really need to read that book to know.
Well, I'm going
to
read the book. I'm going to read the book. I'll read it this weekend. All right?
Okay, thank you. All right, thanks.
Thank you. I thought she was going to talk about Adolf. George, Naperville.
Sean, I agree with what you brought up earlier. The Democrats had full-blooded American values back then. There was ethnic pride, but their allegiance was to America. They put the flag out proudly. They believed in freedom, not slavery. And cowboys and Indians were all over television because they represented the rugged individual making his own way.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what I told my friend from Melrose Park, who I haven't talked to in years. I'll tell you what I told him today. And I blame my relatives, my friends as well. You voted that way, and you turned those neighborhoods into Democrat strongholds because you wanted in on the scam. You knew it was a scam. Melrose Park knows. The Chicago Democrat Party, Mike Madigan, it's a frickin' fix. And they just want in on it. Well, this is what it looks like when you complacently bend knee to a party that has long vision versus your measly frickin' pension and your job. Now look what you did to the country your parents fought for. You turned it into a bastion of corruption that the people they fought thrive in to this day. You happy? You get to sit around, eat linguine and clam sauce, pretend you earned your pension? Oh, that's perfect. Cream Puff Jim, I was talking about
you. Yeah,
chubby.
Hi, Sean. How are you?
Splendid.
How are you? I don't know if you're really existing in the flesh. I have to come out of Florida to see if you're really alive.
Oh, yeah.
But I was talking about Biden's speech about 10 days ago about HUD housing and how to put a roof over the homeless's head.
Well, the government created the homeless problem. Then they keep them high on drugs. I think we should move them in Chicago.
It doesn't matter. Every skeleton on this earth, regardless if you're in the Four Seasons or Rich Carlton, your skeleton and the skeleton next to you.
Oh, are you going to give me the Nietzsche? Are you reading Nietzsche? Are you reading Nietzsche again?
Of course I read Nietzsche.
I could tell who you read. I know who you read. You think you're, come on. Not on your best day back in the 60s when you were svelte and you could see your feet without a mirror.
It was created in the 60s. It was a war of poverty that created it.
Oh, it was created in the 1860s. And once again, you know where that problem exists? Wait a minute.
Yeah, sure.
You know where that problem exists? In your Democrat ghettos and sewers. The good news, Jim, is you can move them right into the business district. You got 5 million vacant acres or square feet.
in what used to be the financial district in the sewer of Chicago. And that's why the developer in Wilmette threw the fundraiser for little Lori Lightfoot. And don't worry, he's got a lot of money. And he's going to get this other Marxist who's going to be your mayor. And before you know it, those people who are victims of policy called the homeless and the poor and the welfare, they'll be living in what used to be business. It doesn't matter because they're not interested in what's best for the city. They're interested in nationalizing that property. See, I read it too. I just looked at it a little differently. I knew Nietzsche was a scumbag who wasn't half as smart as Marx, who hated his father and his mother, but he loved Engels. I think he loved him with his pants off. Lloyd, Gary, Indiana.
Hey, Sean, how you doing?